my God. We have shocking breaking news tonight from the World Cup. U.S. Soccer says journalist Grant Wahl has died while covering the World Cup in Doha. Grant Wahl's wife, Celine Grounder, posted the U.S. Soccer statement on Twitter and wrote, "I am so thankful for the support of my husband Grant Wahl's soccer family and of so many friends who've reached out tonight. I'm in complete shock." Christine Brennan is with me now. This is unbelievable. We were just speaking about the World Cup and in light of the Title IX players, and now we're getting this horrible news about his death. What does the statement say?
Well, Grant, first of all, Laura is a colleague, was a colleague and friend of mine. I've covered many, many soccer tournaments, especially women's soccer tournaments with him. There is no more respected, beloved soccer journalist in the country and potentially in the world than Grant Wahl. And this is absolutely heartbreaking news. It is stunning, shocking. It's just awful news. One of the most talented, lovely human beings you could ever want to meet. What U.S. Soccer has said, looking at it in my phone here, that they are heartbroken to learn that we have lost Grant Wahl. It goes on for quite a few sentences, but fans of soccer and journalism of the highest quality knew we could always count on Grant to deliver insightful and entertaining stories about our game and all the teams and what have you. His passion for soccer and commitment to elevating its profile across our sporting landscape played a major role in helping to drive interest in and respect for our beautiful game. And it may be most important here, Laura, as important as U.S. Soccer is saying in its statement about Grant Wahl, Grant's belief in the power of the game to advance human rights was and will remain an inspiration to all. There's several more sentences, but that is such an important point because it was Grant who was wearing that rainbow T-shirt just a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago, as the World Cup began, and was detained for, I believe it was about a half hour, when the authorities at the stadium, the Qatari authorities, were telling him he couldn't go in with that T-shirt. And what did Grant Wahl do? He didn't take that T-shirt off. He kept it on, and he sat there until one of the supervisors for the Qatari officials in that stadium at the World Cup allowed him to go ahead and do his job with that T-shirt on. That was Grant Wahl.
Unbelievable to know the importance of that message, the importance of what it represented on the world stage at a time when the world was watching, and to think about the loss of such a respected man. And many people know his wife, Celine Grounder. She was, remember, a member of the COVID-19 advisory board transition team for President Biden. She's an American infectious disease specialist. And if it's just unbelievable to think of this tragedy. I have John Berman on the line as well. John, you're an avid fan of the sport and such respect for Grant Wahl. What's your reaction tonight to this horrible news?
I'm gutted. I'm shocked. I first met Grant in 2010 in South Africa covering that World Cup. Grant was just given an award by FIFA, the World Soccer Governing Body, because he was covering his eighth World Cup. This was the eighth World Cup in a row he's covered. He is, as Christine Brennan is the preeminent figure skating journalist on planet Earth, Grant Wahl is the preeminent soccer journalist in America. But more than that, he was just a lovely, lovely, sweet guy. He adored soccer. He wanted to share his love with soccer with everybody, but he never lost sight of what else was important and what was most important wherever he went. He went to Qatar months ago to write an article about the migrant workers there, a very controversial article, a very controversial subject. As Christine said, he wore the rainbow shirt to the first World Cup game. He was, you know, as I said, he's like the top soccer journalist in America, but he always entertained my texts. And I'm just a schmuck soccer fan, and I would weigh in after games with my stupid observations, but Grant would always write back with the sweetest, kindest, most thoughtful notes. It's just such an epic loss. And I do want to say, I mean, I listen to his podcast twice every week. I texted him a few days ago. He's been sick. he had been sick in Qatar. He had something that he was diagnosed as bronchitis or bronchitis-like. He had tested several times for COVID. And according to him on his podcast, had tested negative, but he had been sick. He hadn't been feeling well, but, you know, nothing that would indicate what ultimately happened. And, man, it's just so tragic to hear something like this. He had plans to be there for the entire World Cup, 37 days he was spending in Qatar. He was living in a condo with three other guys, journalists there covering it. That's what you do. You go to the World Cup for the duration. You cover it for the duration. You go to as many games as you can. And that's what he was doing. He had talked about how before the quarterfinals, which were today, he had taken a few days just to rest up because he was so worn out. To hear something like this is just so sad.
John, I can hear it in your voice and just thinking about the anguish that his family must be enduring tonight. We have more. We're learning more information. We will bring it to you as soon as we have it. Learning now about the death of journalist Grant Wahl, so respected in this field, so unparalleled in his ability to convey this love of game for the entire world. He has died while covering the World Cup in Qatar. We'll be back.